aggregating and summarizing data from multiple sheets or reports is time-consuming. Without Pivot App, you may need to create formulas, cell links, cross-sheet references, and hierarchies to combine data. With Pivot App, data is automatically calculated, categorized, and stored, enabling scalable and robust reports or dashboards. To better understand what Pivot App can be used for, let's update the sales dashboard to include metrics on forecasted sales per product line. Pivot App can create these metrics in a way that will also accommodate new products that are added in the future. Currently, each sales rep has a sales pipeline sheet that tracks opportunities. In these sheets, each opportunity has a product type and forecasted amount. Our goal is to aggregate the data for all sales reps so we can build dashboard metrics for the total forecasted amount per product type. To begin with, we can create a report that aggregates the sales pipeline data for all reps. Although this report includes the product category, we cannot use it to build robust metrics that can be used for dashboards. To do this, we could create an additional sheet with formulas to calculate key metrics. But this can become unscalable as it requires someone to manually update the metrics sheet as new product lines are added. So, how can we gather the desired metrics in a scalable solution? This is where Pivot App comes in. To begin with, let's access the Pivot App by selecting the app launcher and then selecting Pivot. In Pivot App, we can create a new pivot sheet by selecting the Create Pivot Sheet button. This will open the configuration menu. Our first step is to select the source data. Pivot allows us to select one source for the pivot sheet, so we will select the report that combines all of our source data. This report aggregates the data from each opportunity sheet with key columns needed for the pivot. Select Next to continue. Now we can configure the design of the output pivot sheet. To do this, we will designate rows, columns, and how to calculate the values within the pivot sheet grid. For the row sections, we will select the Add Field button and then select Product Category. This will make each unique product category from our source report into one row on our pivot sheet. Next, we will move to the columns category and select Add Field. We can now select month to make each month its own column. Lastly, for the values field, we want to display the forecast amount as a sum. Let's select Add Field forecast amount and make sure the dropdown displays sum. Now, we will need to name our pivot workflow. Let's name this sales by product. And finally, we can set the execution frequency, or how often we would like Pivot App to run. Let's set the frequency to 12 hours so the data is updated twice daily. We can now select Next. In the destination menu, we can select where we want our pivot sheet to be saved. In this case, we will select the same workspace as the other assets for the solution. Once our destination is selected, we can name the pivot sheet. We will also name the sheet Sales by Product and select Next. In this last menu, we can confirm our pivot configuration is correct. Since everything looks right, we can select Create. Now on the main Pivot App page, we can see the pivot we just created. If we select the name and select Preview, we can view a summary of the data that will be included on the pivot sheet. If we select Create, Pivot App will run and the data will be included in the pivot sheet. Note that some data will need to be cleaned up to suit our needs. For instance, we can rename the columns to their corresponding months and make the cells currency values. Now we can use this data to create the desired chart widget on our dashboard. The same process could be completed to create sales by region, sales by rep, and more. So, are you ready to try out Smartsheet Pivot App? Check out the